So what on earth is this thing? Well, it's something I decided to build in my free time today. I saw something like this in a little animated cartoon movie one time, and I, of course, don't believe everything I see in an animated cartoon movie. So I had to test the principle for myself. The idea was that they had some kind of little carousel thing, kind of like this, only much fancier. And it had candles on the bottom, supplying a draft of hot air upwards, which caught the blades of a windmill like this, only much fancier, and caused it to turn. And I wasn't sure if this was actually possible or not. So I decided to throw something together real quick and see what would happen. And this is what I've got, and it does actually work. And to demonstrate this thing is not turning on any kind of other power source, I will first stop this thing, and then turn it backwards, and you can see that it will set itself to turning right again. Okay, there's your backwards turn. In a minute, it will be going right again. It's just now right there. It stopped. And it's beginning to turn correctly already. There is no other draft in here to make this thing turn. Otherwise, the candle flames would be flickering, and they're not. In the next part of this video, I'm going to show you how to actually make one of these things easily. This is dirt cheap to make. That candle is dripping, and it leaves a string of drips all the way around on that foil. Okay, so some tips on how to build one of these things. Okay, first off, you'll need some kind of block of wood, fairly heavy, and you drill a hole in it and stick this ballpoint pen in there. I used a Papermate pen, at least I think that's the brand that thing is, and the reason is it has a step in size. This is a 1/4 inch, this is bigger. So it goes down in the hole, fits nice and snug, and it won't just go all the way down in there. Okay, now you need a ballpoint pen because the ball on the end is hard steel, and it will not cause friction against the glass piece here. Now, I'm going to zoom in a bit so that you can see how I actually did this, and how some of this is put together. Okay, so it's wire, two pieces of wire, twisted together. One piece comes up, and the blade is glued on. The other piece comes down here, and it has it's turned up, it's bent upwards on the end, and I heated it up, and pushed the candle down on it, let the wax cool off, and it sticks on there. They're twisted together here, then they're separated where they go around the glass. Then they're twisted back together for the other blade and the other candle. This is a piece of chandelier light bulb that I cut off. Now when you do this, if you're going to cut off a chandelier bulb or any light bulb, you have to open up the bulb to let air in. The easiest way to do that is to take the bottom of the light bulb where the bottom electrical contact is and crush it off there with pliers, being careful not to break the bulb. And then down inside there, there's a piece of glass, which is the actual bottom of the bulb, and if you break that little glass tube, it will let air in, and that'll make it a lot easier to cut without just shattering all in a million pieces. I cut it, scored it around with a glass cutter, and then I gave it a tap right about here on the bulb with the glass cutter. And it mostly broke right, but right here, of course, it kind of got off course. But that's all right. It still works. You set this on here. No oil, no grease, no nothing. Just set it on here. If you were ever to put grease or oil on here, it would gum it up. Oil is so thick, it would make it hard to turn. Ball bearings, sleeve bearings are not good enough. You have to use a pin glass bearing. That's what this is called, a pin glass bearing. You can use a needle right here. Any kind of sharp steel point will work. That's all that's necessary. I used super glue, which is cured by sprinkling baking soda on it, which makes it cure in less than a second. That's what I hooked this all together with. But that's just because I had that on hand. And it's getting a bit hot right here. It's probably going to fail. But we'll see. So that's some tips on how to make one of these things. You could even use a large size test tube here. The main thing is it's not too long. Because if it's too long and it tilts, then it's going to start dragging against the ink pen or whatever it's writing on. If you're going to build one of these things for yourself, be careful how you use it. When those candles get low, they'll fall off of the wires that they're attached to. And when they fall off, they might not go out. And they might even roll off onto the countertop here and try to burn my house down. So if you build one of these things, be careful. Stay near where you can see it. Or else do this out in the welding shop on the steel table. Also, if anyone knows what this thing is called, I'm sure there's a name for this creation. If somebody knows what that name is, please post it in the comments. I'd sure like to know what this thing's actually known as. Well, the baking soda and super glue got too hot and crumbled away, and the blades fell off. So I had to put them back on with paper clips this time. They seemed to hold just fine. Okay, let's see what happens if we increase the speed on this video. Of course, this is fake. It's never going to actually go this fast in real life. But I always like to play around with stuff like this, and I thought it'd be neat to see this thing go around really, really fast. Okay, I guess it's time to come back to reality now. See you later. Have a nice day.